Hello class 8. So in the last video we started talking about refraction of light. We spoke about laws of refraction, two laws of refraction. So let us further continue in this video also talking about, you know, refraction of light. Now the second law of refraction we spoke about, where I told, you know, that is more of a mathematical statement, and the statement was like the ratio, you can see the right hand side is a ratio. The ratio of the sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is a constant. And this constant, I told you, is called refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first. Refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first, remember that. And refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first is denoted by this Greek letter, looks like a U with a trunk, and I told you it is read or pronounced as mu, M-E-W, mu. So mu represents refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first, and it is equal to sine of angle of incidence divided by the sine of angle of refraction. So to say, this equation is your second law of refraction. And I forgot to tell you in that previous video about laws of refraction that this second law of refraction is also called Snell's law, from the name of a person, something Snell, S-N-E-L-L. Okay, so this law was given by a person named Snell, and thereby the name Snell's law. I forgot to mention this in the last previous video. Okay, so mu as written over here is refractive index of the first medium with respect to the second. And do not forget this. When a ray of light comes from a rarer medium to a denser medium, it is initially traveling in this direction, denoted by the dashed line here. So when ray of light comes from rarer to denser medium, it bends towards the normal. Thereby r, the small angle over here, is the angle of refraction. This is the angle of incidence. Likewise, when a ray of light comes from a denser to a rarer medium, the ray of light bends away from the normal. The dashed line here again showing the original direction of the ray of light. Okay, so do not forget this. Another thing, or another expression, or rather another relation that I want to give, that I want to discuss. I haven't given this relation, of course. Okay, it is not my relation. Alright. So I want to discuss about another relation between refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first and the speed of light. Now, the very fact that ray of light bends when it moves from one transparent medium to another is because light travels with different speeds in different media. In this radar medium, it's a radar medium, it's not very dense, okay? So light can travel very fast. Now, it encounters this, you know, all of a sudden it encounters this denser medium. Alright, so what happens? It takes time to move through that. So it will travel with a lesser speed in a denser medium. It's like we traveling through a, you know, we have a corridor, okay? There's no person standing, there's no crowd, so to say, in that corridor, so we can freely run. Then all of a sudden we come across another corridor which is very crowded. So it will be very difficult for us to move through that crowded corridor, isn't it? So it's something like that for the ray of light. So denser medium, you have molecules packed together. So it's like it's very crowded. Denser medium is very crowded. So ray of light finds it difficult to move through that. So it moves with a lesser speed in a denser medium. Whereas in a rarer medium, it travels with a faster speed. No, you know, resistance or no opposition to its movement, so to say. Alright? So since light travels with different speed in different media, therefore refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first is also given by the ratio of speed of light in the first medium divided by speed of light in the second medium. So you should remember this relation for refractive index. And also this relation, a star, asterisk over here means it's important. Alright, so refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first is also given by speed of light in first medium divided by speed of light in the second medium. Remember that. Now, say ray of light is coming from air. If the first medium is air, the radar medium is air, and the denser medium is glass, say for example. So a ray of light is coming from air and entering glass. So obviously it will bend towards the normal, of course. Okay? But the speed of light in air is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meters per second. Whereas in glass, the speed of the same light is 2 into 10 to the power 8 meters per second. So what is the refractive index of glass with respect to air, if you're asked that? So refractive index, since I'm talking about glass and air pair of media, we can have anything. We can have air and glass, we can have glass and air. So the pair of media concerned could be different. So since we are specifically talking about glass and air media over here, so let me write refractive index of glass with respect to air. Glass is the second medium over here, so I write it here. Okay, in the second place, so to say. The first place is occupied by air. So we read this as refractive index of glass with respect to air is equal to speed of light in, the first medium is air, so air. The first medium is air, the first place is occupied by air, so in air, divided by speed of light in glass. The second place is glass, so this is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meters per second, divided by 2 into 10 to the power 8 meters per second. Meter per second, meter per second, they divide each other out. 10 to the power 8, 10 to the power 8, they divide each other out, so we get 3 upon 2. This is 1.5. So you can see, refractive index does not have a unit. Refractive index is a unitless quantity, remember that. Because it is the ratio of the same two quantities, ratio of speed to speed, ratio of sine of I to sine of R. Okay, so it's the ratio of same two things, so therefore it is unitless. So what we get is therefore, refractive index of glass with respect to air is 1.5. So you might get numericals this way, remember. You might get the speed of light in the first medium, you might get the speed of light in some second medium. So you'll be asked, what is the refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first? This is exactly how you need to do it. Is that understood, class 8? So, with this, mind you, second law of refraction is called Snell's law. Do not forget, like I forgot to tell you in the previous video. Alright, let me erase all these stuffs. You can pause the video and copy, okay? One last thing I want to tell you today is effect of refraction. There are many effects of refraction of light. Like for example, you place a pencil or a pen in a cup filled with water. You will see it appears to you, so this is your cup or bowl of water. So you place your pencil over here, so this is your pencil, half length outside the surface of water. It will appear to you that the pencil is bent like this. It appears to you that the pencil is bent. Obviously, this is because of refraction of light. A pen or a pencil appears bent in, B empty bent of course, in water. So this is one of the effects of refraction, remember. The other effect is, a swimming pool, when seen from above, when you look at this swimming pool from above, it appears less deep. Okay, so if you think the swimming pool is not very deep and you jump into the swimming pool, okay, you will find it's very deep, remember. Okay, so a swimming pool having a greater depth appears less deep. It is, of course, because of refraction of light. A swimming pool appears less deep. So this is another effect of refraction of light, remember.
Okay, so let me erase this picture.
Not just a swimming pool, okay, you take a glass of water, alright, and you look at the glass of water from above, the glass appears less deep. Okay, so it's not just true for swimming pool. Anything having water or any kind of a liquid, be it oil, okay, it will appear less deep. Understood? That is because of refraction of light. The third example that we can give is early sunrise. Early sunrise and late sunset. Many a times what happens is, although the sun is well below the horizon, okay, so this is the horizon, you are standing over here, so this is the horizon, so the sun actually is somewhere over here, before sunrise I'm talking about, okay, but it appears to you, what happens is, the ray of light coming from the sun, it undergoes bending of light, since the different layers of air has different density. The air, the atmosphere is not uniformly dense. So, the air is not uniformly dense, so the ray of light coming from the sun undergoes refraction, that is bending of light, when it travels from one layer of air to another, it undergoes bending of light and it reaches your eyes like this. So it appears to you as if the sun is somewhere over here. Already it appears as if the sun has risen, when actually the sun is below the horizon. Okay, exactly the same thing in case of sunset. The sun has already set, but it appears to you, the very same way it appears to you that the sun is somewhere over here, yet to set, so to say. Understood? So, early sunrise and late sunset is also because of refraction of light. And the fourth one is the phenomenon of mirage. I don't know whether you've heard of mirage or not, I believe you have. So, mirage is seen in the desert. So I am traveling in the desert, okay, it's a very hot and, you know, sunny day, very hot. So I'm traveling in the desert, so it appears to me as if, okay, I have seen a pool of water. Okay, because I also see the image, the inverted image, so to say, of a tree. Alright, and some bushes around the pool of water. Okay, so it appears to me, it seems to me as if there is some water and, you know, I'm seeing the reflection of a tree on the water. So I quickly go to that place, okay, but I see there is no water. There is no tree, no water, nothing. Okay, so that is an illusion actually that we see in the desert. And that illusion is because of refraction of light, and which is called, the illusion itself is called a mirage. Okay, now you don't need to go into the technicalities of how refraction causes mirage. But do remember, these are the different phenomena or the effects that we get to see because of refraction of light. Okay, so I think this much will do for this video. Thank you. Bless you.